What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Dev back again for another first listen to my nigga Plizank. Can't see it, nigga. Sunshine in his face. But yeah, today we're gonna listen to a different sound. Today we're gonna listen to Sid. I say Sid. Y'all might say Side. I say Sid. You know, I'm gonna say how I wanna say it, alright? From the internet, she's a singer on the internet with the vocals. You know, I've listened to the internet, man. I liked their album. It just had a lot of different sounds to it. You know, they were using real instruments, and it was really soulful. It was just like one of them, you know, alternative sounds. It make you feel good, man, when you listen to the internet, man. Now she got her solo album. I'm expecting a lot of R&B in it, you know, a lot of singing, because her vocals are really nice, man. Like, she has like a really amazing voice, and you know, it's just one of those voices you hear and you just can't help but to just, damn, like this girl got some talent. So with that being said though, you know, been fucking talking too much. I know she's a part of our future too, so you know, them motherfuckers is talented and they own each and own way, you know, kind of like, you know, they got that feel that everybody kind of like copies now, where everybody wants to be weird and different. So I feel like that's where our future comes in. You know, I fucks with our future. So with that being said though, been fucking talking too much like always. Let's get right into this. We got Sid Finn. Sid Finn. Y'all ready? Alright, we got track one. Shake 'em off. First track, man, you see how like it got a different sound. Like, I don't know how she does it. Who's producing the tracks, first of all? Let me know that in the comments below. Yeah, man, but her voice is just amazing, man. She got that one voice, you know, it's that unique voice that everybody just attunes to, man. You know, it gets you, and it's just like, damn, this girl can really blow. Like, this shit crazy. We got track two. No. I just got the blue screen. It's all good. We right back, right on the phone. Wait, why I felt like she had like a little Aaliyah vibe right there? I know I can't be the only one, man. Man, let me know if y'all felt the same below, bruh. Cause I felt like I'm like, damn, they've been blowing, bruh. Alright, we got track three, No Complaints. Shit, no complaints from me so far. Rapping right there, it was a little, you know, upbeat tempo. It wasn't really R&B track, but it was something different. I'm a little neutral towards that, a little neutral. Alright, we got track four. Nothing to Something. Shit, ain't that the truth? I'm too much off the blues, so give me the juice.
Damn, okay, I understand now.
From what I'm getting so far, man, like, just the sound of this album, it sounds like she's got Aaliyah influence, which is not bad, you know. She probably looked up to Aaliyah. Who didn't look up to Aaliyah, you know? Princess Angel dying so early. But, yeah, man, she definitely got that Aaliyah sound, man. Like, you know, that soothing voice, nice, soft. It's a nice tone, man. Like, all right, we got track 5, All About Me. They had like a little dark vibe to it. Sound like a little medieval sound, you know, that like a little medieval sound. But I like to be her lyrics were there too. Like I said, man, you know, pure R&B album right here, man. She got talent, man, obviously. You know, all future people got talent. For real, man. Even if it's in a weird way, they got their own set amount of talent. So you know, she definitely doing her thing right here so far. You know, not a bad track I didn't like on here. And you know how I feel about short albums. You know, because I see I got 12 tracks on here. You see how I feel about short albums. I like short albums. Because, you know, I feel like you're getting straight to the point. You know, you're giving everything you got. All right, we got track 6, Smile More. Just to see you smile more. Jazz spots, the lights dim down low, you just sitting back there and they're playing that soothing music. I feel like that what that track was right there, man. Just one of them tracks that it just puts you in that mood. You're just like, damn, okay, I feel it. You speaking to me spiritually, you know, mentally. I'm hearing you, you know, I'm feeling you. That's what I feel like that track is right there. All right, track 7, Got Her Own. She got her own. She got her own. Another one, you know, she giving a message to the ladies, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I respect that. I respect that. Not too like in between. Wasn't really favoring it, wasn't really hating it. Little in between, neutral towards it. Alright, we got track 8, Drown In It. If you want me to, oh, Drown In It. Okay. I try to make it right. It's over? Oh man, I thought that track was actually kind of straight. And I'm in there like, okay, you know, vibing, sliding. That was one of the good tracks right there. I fucks with that one, even though it was a 1 minute track. All right, we got track 9, Body. Body. Damn! That might be my favorite track on the album. Hey, you know what? I don't give a fuck. Y'all can say what y'all want, but that shit sexy right there, man. That's that sexy shit right there. You feel me? You using that bitch. Hey. I posted that track, man. Hey, she was doing her thing on it. Hey, her vocals are amazing. They just in my ear, and I'm just like, oh, shit, girl. You speaking to me, man. I feel you. You know, like, oh, shit. You know? I posted that. Hey, let me put some respect on her name. How you say it? Sid? Side, come on, man. Side, Sid, I want to get it right. I don't want to throw no disrespect to her name. Y'all let me know in the comments below. I know y'all got special ways of, like, explaining to me. Woo! Damn, got a nigga hot. You know what I'm saying? Got a nigga hot. All right, we got track 10, Dollar Bills. Hey, man, that track right there, man. Let me know who that was in the end singing, because I didn't know who that was. But that's a solid track. I liked it. I liked it. Wasn't that body, but you know, I liked it. All right, we got track 11 over. Woo! I've been waiting for this one. Hey, y'all know when I did that black review, I was like, man, I didn't even know who this was. And y'all saw the black review, man. I'm going to throw that bit down the bottom. Y'all can see it. I'm sitting here like, okay, you know, black, I didn't know who he was. New artist, that motherfucker raw. So if black and Sid on the track together, man, this shit got to be fire. And she put black on a feature. Okay, I respect that. You know that this is useless. Don't need to make excuses. We both know what the truth is, love. For real. How you gonna look for help when you don't know your fucking self? Alright? That's true. That's true. I fuck with that. See what that track was about, you know, relationships being over, you know, separating. Like, we both know what the picture is, but y'all still staying together. You know what the deal is. Sometimes you know what it is. Like, you know what the deal is. You're just trying to keep that fire because, you know, you've been with somebody for so long. But, you know, sometimes you just need to know when to let it go. You know, you need to let it know. You know, sometimes you get a little unhealthy. And, yeah, like, you can't spark a struck match. You know what I'm saying? If the shit already struck and the fire is out. The fire is out. Shit ain't coming back. You ain't restriking that match, all right? So let that be known. You know, that's just a track right there saying, you know, for the relationships out there, if it's over, you need to let it go. Somebody need to be the bigger person and let it go. Me am the rant for the night. We got track 12, the last track, Insecurity. On that album. Well, first of all, let me say this, man. I think I'm proud. You know, when I looked up the internet long ago last year, and then, you know, even this year, you know, the publicity they're getting and the fan base that they have is just amazing. But one thing, you know, I want to put light on is the fact that nobody's really saying anything about her sexuality. Like, nobody's really coming across, you know, being rude about it, being, you know, disrespectful or anything. You know, they just they listening to the music, they're appreciating the music, you know, for what she does, not for, you know, who she likes or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Because everybody can like who they want, you know, nobody should be judged by who they like. That's I think that's one problem. So, you know, her being lesbian or whatever or whatnot, or bisexual, you know, that doesn't bother me at all, because I got gay cousins, whatever, whatnot, but that doesn't bother me at all, because, you know, I'm just here for the music, I'm here for her talent. And as a person, you know, she sounds like she's a very cool person, and she got a lot of talent. So that's what I'm here for. I got no disrespect. And I feel like we all feel the same way, because I haven't seen any really hateful comments towards her. Like, even when I look through, like, YouTube comments and, you know, her Twitter and whatnot, not a lot of people dislike her. And how could you? Because, you know, she got talent, man. Her voice is amazing. The music is amazing. It just gives you that feel, man. Like, it's just amazing music. So, let me just give you a little rant right there. But back to the album, man. My opinions on the album. Look, I feel like the album was... it was very good. For an R&B album, it was really good. Her solo album... without the, you know, the rest of the members and the internet. But I feel like, yo, that Body song was my favorite track on there. Like, you know, it had me, you know, nigga, woo, nigga, shoo. You know, I was about to call up a botting, you know, I'm like, hey, be that eight, you know. But no, for real though, man, that Body track was probably my favorite. Man, her vocals are amazing, man. I feel like she has like Aaliyah-esque in her, it's just a reminder. It reminds me of me being back in, you know, 97, 98. Listen to Aaliyah all on the radio, man. It was amazing, bro. Like, her voice is just pure. I just can't say no much more about it, man. Her voice is pure. I like it. I feel like she's gonna have a lot of talent going forward. And like I said, man, numerous times, she got mad talent. Like, she's gonna make it in this industry. Her music is pure. It's just amazing. It's just a joy to listen to. And yeah, man, very soothing to the ears. I just don't know. It's just R&B sexy track, man. Her voice is just, it's just one of those voices that just grasp you. You know, grasp you by the head. You're just like, yo, listen to me. I'm just like, all right. Let me just try this shit out. I'm just like, damn, this shit. You can't hate. You can't. You could be the most thug nigga ever and turn that shit on and be like, damn. All right, I fucks with this. But, hey, man, hey, like always, thank y'all for support. Thank y'all for subscribing. I got the best 55,000 subs out. 55,000 subs out there, man. Y'all always support me, and I appreciate that to the max. Like I said, man, February's gonna be a strong month for me, so I'm gonna put a lot of videos out. I'm gonna try best I can while working. But like always, been fucking talking too much. Until the next time, we out. It's been your boy Dev.